In what looks like police interaction with a wild protest or something, especially lately in America, it was not that. There was a group of parents outside of their kids' Thompson Ranch Elementary School fighting with cops that we saw folks getting tased, bleeding on the ground, arrested. It was a chaotic scene. It looked a lot like what we saw outside of Uvalde, outside in that school down in Uvalde, Texas, a couple months ago after that horrific shooting, because there was a reported lockdown and gunman at this particular school. So of course parents reacted in this particular way. And the reason that they're clashing with cops was somewhat similar to what was going on down in Texas. But first, there was a big part about that, and this is the moment that all hell broke loose down at this situation, is the gun hit the ground. I want you guys to see where it came from and also how it was handled. Watch that part again. That father in the blue shirt had the gun, dropped it. Then the tasering started happening with multiple parents there. Some more details, because in the end, three people were arrested, two of whom were shocked with stun guns after they tried to enter the grounds at, again, Thompson Ranch Elementary School. That's in the city of El Mirage in Arizona. Arizona authorities said that officers arrived at the scene shortly after someone there reported a man who appeared to have had a handgun and was trying to gain access to the school. The man then fled in an unknown direction. Officers sought to make sure that there was no longer a threat on the grounds, during which time is when they discovered a suspicious package that the police said was ultimately examined and explosive technicians had rendered safe. So all these potential tragedies or potential things happened, but it seems like the police had it together. And this is when everything went sideways, when folks showed up and wondered why the school was in lockdown and why they weren't taking care of their kids, because they were getting flashbacks of what we saw in Texas. So again, more on this. One adult was hospitalized from injuries from the taser. All three adults will face charges for pushing officers and attempting to enter the school while it was on lockdown. The parent that was armed will also be charged with having a weapon on campus. After a search of the area, police did locate the man who tried to get into the school. Police say he's currently being evaluated by mental health professionals and has criminal charges pending. It's unknown what the suspicious item was that caused the evacuation, that package that they checked to make sure it wasn't an explosive or anything like that. So more on this, because this is one person who saw it and experienced it, and she was saying what she went through with the cops. An account given to KPNX TV in Arizona, Darlene Gonzalez, whose daughter was inside the school, said after parents were told the lockdown threat was over, she and her son sought to enter the school but were told to go to the library. At that point, she said the situation escalated and she was thrown to the ground. She added that the gun, excuse me, was seen in the video belonged to her son. Chief Paul Amarzoka of the El Mirage Police Department said that those involved in the altercation had broken the law and bore responsibility for what had happened. He says this: one doesn't get to create this chaos at a school in an emergency situation and just walk away. There's a lot that went down here, Burbank. A whole lot that went down here. And I feel like there's some shades of Uvalde and Robb Elementary down there and what we saw outside of there. And people are traumatized. There's also aspects about that gun. There's so many things. I wonder what you think about this whole situation.
I mean, to say you can't distract from an emergency situation and cause a scene, okay, we could say the same thing about the police and hold them accountable for their behavior here this day. What happened outside of Uvalde was disgusting. And this almost seems worse. I mean, just the physical violence right off the gate from these police officers. These parents want to protect their kids, or they want to convince, they shouldn't have to, the police officers to protect their kids. They're not getting in the way of the cops doing their job. They are trying to get the cops to do their job. And it's kind of a sign that we're just devolving. This idea that the police are there to protect and serve, I think people are waking up to they don't do that, and they really have never done that for most communities in America. They've mostly existed to protect property, and that's a big problem. And so now we're at this point where we have to recreate these social structures for ourselves. We have to create our own community response team to respond to situations like this if the police aren't going to do it. And it's like we're starting from scratch, and we're going to eventually have some shadow government because the government isn't working for us in the United States. I mean, GoFundMe is basically our national healthcare at this
point. It's the first thing right away when something happens in any kind of moment. Oh, well, they must have a GoFundMe. And then, of course, you have to make sure that it's valid, because then maybe some people who want to capitalize off of that situation. Anyways, that's a whole separate conversation. But think about this way. I'm wondering what you think about my thought here is, everyone was in the right here. Everyone was in the right here. The police said, we have the situation handled. We put the school on lockdown to prevent your children from having any situation. The guy ran off, we're gonna go get him, right? Eventually they caught up with him. Checked out the suspicious package, it's all good. They did the right thing. Parents showed up, saw cops not telling them that information. Maybe that's the wrong thing the cops did. And the parents did the right thing. Well, F this. This isn't Rob Elementary School. I just saw this horrific movie. I'm not gonna let it happen. So they're like, we're charging in. One parent shows up with a gun. You know why? Because in America, we've told everyone, hey, you gotta arm yourself. The only thing that can kill a bad guy with a gun is a good guy with a gun. So of course, the guy who thinks he's a good guy with a gun is gonna show up with his gun to protect his kid or whoever it was, his family member in that school. F the cops. I'll die today if that's what it takes, because I'm not gonna let my kid see that fate, right? So everyone thinks they're in the right. We have guns everywhere. This is Arizona. We got guns everywhere. Why wouldn't this parent think he can bring his gun out there and protect his kid? Cops that are like, we have the situation handled. But the cops now are in a situation where we've seen it happen in a whole different state where they didn't do the right thing. And even though cops maybe have the situation handled, they don't communicate. Calm down, everything is good. Instead, it's aggression and it's get back. They started snatching on the guy before he dropped his gun. You saw that part, because that guy was agitated. The reason he's agitated is because he's worried about his kid. It sucks because everybody's in the right, but there's so much wrong.
Yeah, I think it's an interesting take, JR. You're very fair. I think it is good to point out that, yeah, maybe the police didn't do a good job communicating to these parents what had happened, what was going on, and also, why are we in a situation where people don't trust police in the first place?
Exactly.
Like, why do they arrive and immediately start reacting this way? Because of, I think you're right, what happened in Uvalde. And it's a bad situation, right? They say a good guy with a gun is the response to bad guys with a gun. So the parent shows up with the gun, ends up scrapping with the police. Scary situation that we're going to end up. Yeah. We're gonna end up creating our own, you know, public goods, our own public systems, because the government isn't working for us. It's kind of shocking.
I just want to thank you for going and letting my all folks were in the right argument fly there. You're like, I understand what you're saying. You're too nice. It's all fine. It's okay. Fine.